Hey guys, what's up? We're back with some more Destiny 2 action, and I just want to make this video very quickly to talk about a bow that I kinda wrote off in the bow review that I did for Destiny 2. So as you know, I have three of the bows. Apparently there's five bows that exist in the game. One of them is a raid bow, which I'm not gonna get for a very long time because the raid is level 550. And one of them is the exotic bow, which I'm not gonna get because it's an exotic bow. And I don't have that really good RNG. Now the Arsenic Bow, Arsenic Bite, is the arc-based recurve bow. Arsenic Bite 4B. I don't know why it's called 4B, maybe there's a 4A, 4D, I don't know. Anyway, this bow, turns out, is actually pretty good, specifically because Explosive Head is a trait that you can get on the bow. Now this is a bow that doesn't actually have random rolls. You can actually get this from collections then. I don't really understand how collections work, but supposedly you can actually grab the bow or maybe not, I don't know, but this bow is supposed to not have random traits yet, cannot reacquire randomized gear. Okay, anyway, unlike the no turning back bow, which definitely has random rolls, Arsenic Bite and, sorry, not no turning back, unlike Subtle Calamity, which most certainly has randomized rolls, Arsenic Bite and no turning back don't have randomized rolls, so it is definitely worth picking up this weapon because you'll definitely get Explosive Head as a potential trait. And because of Explosive Head, it just means that this weapon can do AoE damage, and because this weapon can do AoE damage, it automatically has a spot over, what is this? Lol, what do I need this for? It definitely has a place as opposed to, say, Subtle Calamity, because Subtle Calamity doesn't have any chance of, well, Subtle Calamity has a chance of getting, I don't know what to do with this. Subtle Calamity has a chance of getting Explosive Head, but without Explosive Head, Subtle Calamity is just a single target bow, meaning that there is actual reason to use Arsenic Bite. And also the thing about Arsenic Bite is that when you kill something, you get the Rampage perk, and the Rampage perk means that your next attack will do even more damage, and that seems to also apply to the explosive head damage. So if you kill someone, your Explosive Head seems to also do more damage. I'll need to test that more and do like a proper test, but so far my observations appear to support this particular fact. I don't know why I decided to enter a public event, because it's not going to give me anything that I actually need, but whatever, let's just keep going. Now, I was going to make this short, but I guess I'll make this about the length of a heroic event. Oh, it's done. Okay, that was fast. Another thing that did happen for my bows is that I actually went ahead and put a Masterwork Core into my No Turning Back. So my No Turning Back is a Masterwork bow, which means that if I kill a bunch of dudes, I will get myself a good old fashioned Orb of Light, as I just did right there. So that definitely makes my No Turning Back a very strong bow, and it gives it a reason for me to just use it on a very regular basis. Of course, not it being a kinetic damage bow, like I said in my bow review, means that supposedly it does less damage, especially towards shields, so I'll have to like sort of figure out what I want to do with that. That being said, this bow is actually pretty good now. I can see why people seem to like this. Of course, nobody bloody told me that this bow actually had access to friggin' Explosive Head. If they did, I would have immediately put it as close to Subtle Calamity as I would have. Basically now all three bows are in the same sort of tier. They're all really good and they all seem to have their purpose, but if I got my Subtle Calamity with Explosive Head, it would have instantly been the best bow in the game. Specifically for Warlocks, specifically for anyone with Nezorak Sin, because, you know, void damage, hello, easy. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like button. If you really enjoyed it, maybe consider subscribing to the channel. I always have a archery fetish, so if I do get the next bow, if I do happen to get the raid bow, you can be absolutely certain I'm going to make a video on that, but, you know, first I have to actually jump to the raid, which is not going to happen for a while. But until next time, I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Oh, I'm dead. Bye.